You're listening to the Soulless Minions. And note, I did not say alternative DVD commentaries because folks. Hi, Josh.
Hi.
This is not a typical, or this is not a commentary episode at all. This is a test episode, one of two, that we're doing for our listeners. And we're hoping you can tell us whether or not this idea will work. It's just supposed to be a kind of a short, quick burst kind of a show.
Come on, we're not talking to Congress.
Oh, my God.
Anyway, is it good or bad? That's all we want to know.
So do please give this a listen and tell us whether or not this is good or bad. Leave something in the comments and let us know how it is.
Or
anything
email
we
us.
Can do to improve it.
Email us. Our email is in the show notes.
Yeah. So with that said, here we go. Hey, Josh.
Yeah, Justin.
Do you remember that show, Buck Rogers?
I do.
What do you remember about Buck Rogers, Josh?
I remember...
Where you going, Buck?
I remember Aaron Gray. That's the...
Colonel Wilma Deering.
That's the actress's name.
That's right.
Which I always get backwards. I think the character's name is supposed to be Aaron Gray because it's such a cool name. And then they say her name is Wilma.
Yeah,
and I'm thinking... That's wrong. They should just have kept her real name. Erin Gray sounds like a cool name. Like Wilma? That sounds so lame. Why would you do that? Let's start off right off the bat with the thing that got me the most excited, which was Erin Gray.
Mm-hmm. Are you talking about like back in the day watching it as a kid?
Yeah. As a kid. I don't remember how old I was.
I think she was probably a lot of guys our age. One of our first early crushes.
Okay, yeah, you know? Let's just get to it. Yeah, if she was. Okay, I don't know how old I was, but I was young, and I wasn't into girls yet. I don't think I knew that girls were a thing.
Right.
I was clearly too young. We were watching this as reruns somewhere in the 80s, obviously. And
we saw it on a
rerun.
It's a rerun.
You'll find out.
I remember watching it, and... being and feeling excited whenever Erin Gray came on screen, and I couldn't figure out why.
Why are my pants getting tighter?
Yeah, it was like, I remember her in that.
Her outfit.
Yeah, it's like a teal color.
No, it's white.
Well, yeah, she wears white, but there was another. The other words like green or something like that. But it's like very, very.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's very.
That's like her casual.
Yeah, it's very form fitting, and I'm like. Yeah. I remember that one over the white one, and I remember thinking, like, there could be something to this. I think I like this. I don't know why, but I'm taking notes. And... I remember really liking the show. I remember there not being a lot of it. It wasn't in our lives for very long because, as I didn't know, it was canceled after two seasons, right? Mm-hmm. Two seasons. I remember the Hawk character. I did know at the time that the Hawk character only existed for the second season.
Mm-hmm.
And looking at him now, he looks completely ridiculous. I remember the Hawk character being cool at the time. He's got that cool name, but he's really like... got feathers on his head, and when you
he
look
really
at
does
him,
have feathers on his head. Yes. But he's wearing this cool black outfit, and the actor himself plays it totally straight.
Oh yeah, totally.
And he has a very like dynamic look.
Yeah,
to
he
him.
Doesn't look cool like
if
the
it wasn't
Hawk,
for the hair.
He doesn't look cool like the Hawk from Spencer for Hire.
No, different Hawk.
Different kind of Hawk. Remember Spencer for Hire, Justin?
I do remember Spencer for Hire.
Okay, well this episode isn't about that. Of course, it has a great theme song. There's the other thing.
Mm-hmm.
Classic theme song, classic opening. They don't make him like that anymore. I probably remember that more than anything else, along with Erin Gray.
And Tweaky.
There's the other part. Okay, Tweaky. I did his trademark sound at the start of the show. Tweaky, as I remember, had a thing around him that was Tweaky.
No.
Like the computer part was that thing around his neck, and it hung around his chest. right? Okay. That was him?
No. Okay.
I thought the body just was like hold the on, vessel hold, you, to carry get, him.
You, no.
You're getting ahead of myself.
You're mixing two things.
I am.
So Tweaky was the, you know, 2.5-3 foot robot hung around his neck for portability purposes, although not all the
Doctor
time,
something.
Was Dr. Theophilus. Theophilus. Sorry.
Theophilus, okay.
And he was one of the council for, you know, New Earth. And
different voices for each, right?
Oh, yeah, because Tweaky was a completely separate character. Right. Tweaky did not talk very much. He would do the beep, 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 and then he would say, you know, like, where are you going,
Wasn't
Buck?
That Mel Blanc?
That was Mel Blanc.
Right, right.
For all of season one, then they dropped him for, like, say, the first half of season two, and then they brought him back.
Yeah, they changed voices.
Yeah, this show was kind of like, at this point, partly famous for how it completely tanked itself in the second season.
It makes no sense. Like, it worked well in the first season, and then they retooled it for no reason, and they made it
shitty.
Yeah,
boy, did they. And made it bad. Like,
it was not great.
It wasn't
to start
great
with.
Before.
It was fun.
But it worked.
It was fun.
It worked. It was working, you know? Yeah. And then, yeah, they come. And we don't just mean they changed a few characters. They changed the entire format of the show.
They did. I think I know why they may have done that. I think to avoid what some people call like the sophomore slump, right? Like they retooled it to keep things fresh. Like, do you remember when they did the Batman show, Adam West Batman show?
Yeah.
Like they kept doing it in the same
thing over and
format.
Over.
Eventually got tired and the audience left.
Yeah.
So with Buck Rogers, which is kind of like in the same ballpark of being kind of cheesy, it's kind of campy. And it's fun. They're like, well, that can only last for so long. We got to change things up, or we're, you know, we got to shake it up, or else people are going to get bored. It's like changing the format of a radio station.
But I mean, after the first season, give it a little bit. I mean,
I agree they were premature, but
not
I think
only did they, change
I think they were just trying to stay ahead of the game. And
well, they maybe they
I
went
think
too
they
far.
Made a, I think they made a mistake.
And not only was the format change not a good idea, but it was like the idea for the format was bad. Like it took everything that worked and got rid of it.
Yeah.
It was amazing.
Yeah, they took Erin Gray out of that outfit that made that character. They put her in some kind of like flight attendant outfit or something.
Yeah. Boy,
or
it was
or
bad.
Like cruise ship
and,
outfit.
Yeah. They stopped being on this, you know, quote unquote New Earth thing.
Yeah.
They were on a spaceship.
Yeah.
And it wasn't Buck Rogers anymore. Something was off. It never felt right. I just rewatched the entirety of the complete series, which amounts to one season, of Battlestar Galactica, done by the same people. And I thoroughly enjoyed that show. I actually expected to sit down and watch it and be bombarded with the cheese that was Buck Rogers. And it really wasn't. It had a couple moments, but those were just more elements of the time.
It's earnest, right?
It was earnest. And it was a good show, actually. And I was actually quite surprised to find out when I was rewatching Battlestar that if you had put a gun to my head, I would have said Buck Rogers came first. And when that show tanked, they were like, well, let's use what sets we have and retool and make a new show, that being Battlestar Galactica. But I was backwards. Battlestar came first. And
yeah, I would have thought it was the other way.
Yeah, because in my mind, Battlestar, especially as I started watching that season, was so much better, not just in story, but in production value. Like, it was just a better all-around show and less cheesy. So I felt like this was more getting into the later 80s where they were taking it seriously versus the kind of camp of, say, that early late 70s stuff. But I was wrong. Battlestar came first, and one of the reasons why Battlestar got canceled was it was expensive to produce. So they cut that, but then they said, well, we've got all this stuff. Let's do another cheaper show. So they did Buck Rogers in its place, which is why so many of the elements are very, very similar. Like, you could almost imagine that Buck Rogers is the historical past of Battlestar Galactica, because like their worlds are so similar. It's very strange.
You mean like it takes place in the same universe?
Like it's the same universe.
Okay.
Just in the past. But yeah. Buck came after, and I found that really odd because Buck is really not that good. Our brother recently watched the entire first season and actually gave it to me to watch, and he told me he really struggled to get through that season. I actually rewatched that opening TV movie just recently. Mm-hmm. And I had owned it before, so I was definitely familiar with. It starts off with one of the worst title credit sequences I've ever seen. It's awful. And then goes into the movie. And the movie was okay. Gil Gerard was a good-looking cat back then. He's not now, but he was back then. And he had a charm and charisma.
What happened to him? Did he get wrinkly? Or
he got heavy.
Oh,
he let himself go. I don't know what happened.
He Marlon Brando'd himself.
That's exactly okay. what he did. He went from this young, striking guy to you're just like, what happened, dude?
Okay.
Whereas Erin Gray has aged like a fine wine, you know? I'd marry her today. But you see the writing on the wall with that pilot. You can see where it's not going to work. It feels, even though it was made in the 80s, early 80s, it feels trapped in the 70s. The music is 70s. It's like disco. You know, bum, 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 bum,
yeah, bum, bum, bum. I would have, you know, in my memory, I just always thought it was late 70s.
I know. Because it feels
so
horrible.
Right
it now. Must have felt horribly out of date even in the time it was made. It's very strange to me. It's kind of surreal when you realize when it was produced.
What year was it again?
I want to say Battlestar was made in 79. So I believe Buck would have been probably 81. No, I take that back because they tried to do Galactica 1980, which means that Buck would have been 81 or 82 at the latest.
That's still like there's 70s remnants hanging around.
Yes, there were, but like I said, when you watch Battlestar,
disco
you don't
get
any
died
of that.
Yet.
No, it hadn't. But you don't see any of that in Battlestar. And it and they have scenes of people dancing and all that, and it doesn't feel like that. That's why it's so strange. I feel like it should have taken place before. The faults in the show were built into it from day one. They decided on a certain tact for the show, and they committed to it. I think they knew exactly what they were doing. I think they were intending for some camp. You know, when they have Tiger Man, which is Princess Ardala, who's stunning. She's kind of like the foil for the first season. She's the main baddie.
All right.
She has her henchman, Tiger Man, who's just this big lumbering muscle guy.
Does he talk?
If he does, I don't even remember. I want to say he's like a mute. But
is he like the mountain from Game of Thrones?
Yeah, kind of. Okay. Kind of. Only goofy, like in its presentation, because like
it's called Tiger Man and it's goofy.
He never
really
gets it done right. Like he always feels, oh, you know. Okay. And actually rewatching that pilot episode, it was actually kind of hard to watch because Wilma Deering's character, Erin Gray, she starts off very firm and very masculine towards Buck, and she wants nothing to do him. She thinks he's a spy and all this stuff. Halfway through the we're talking like a 90-minute, you know, TV movie. Halfway through it, she does this 180 where she just decides she's in love with him now. And she keeps putting moves on him. And even he's taken aback, going, What are you doing? You know? And
the producers just suddenly changed tone. Huh?
It feels like they did. Okay. And it just feels so strange. And there's elements of it that don't date. Maybe part of that is the male-female dynamic of the time interfering with the way the show was made. The music, like what's supposed to be like the source music, that bum, 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 you know,
right?
That's horrible.
A great rendition.
I feel like I nailed it.
Okay.
But it's horrible.
Box over here.
Buck as a character is interesting. I mean, obviously it was a you know, comic strip and a, you know, the serials in the past, a man out of time.
It's kind of an odd name, don't you think? It doesn't work in
Buck Rogers.
Unless his last name is Rogers. Buck?
It does sound future-y, Buck? Almost. Buck. Oh, and
I think of Uncle Buck.
While we are, okay, there's another show that I feel rips this show off. It goes completely in its own direction.
Okay.
But Buck Rogers is a man who was, you know, frozen for 500 years, was it? No, yeah. More than that. Was it 500?
I think it was 500.
Something like that. And he's a man out of time.
Right.
Now, as Buck Rogers, the show, continues, I feel they got further and further away from that concept and he just became of the time he was in.
Acclimated.
He acclimated way too quickly.
Yeah.
But another show did something extremely similar.
Farscape?
Yes. Which, as I watched it, I always felt like this is the concept of Buck Rogers, only stirred around a little bit because he wasn't out of time. He was in just a different part of space, completely removed from Earth.
Right.
And that, they never let go of the fact that he was an outsider to their part of the universe.
You're right.
He was constantly making movie jokes, movie references, lines, and quotes that we, the audience, would laugh at. But there was literally an episode where one of the blue alien characters goes, "Hey, I love you, John Crichton," that's the main character, "but half of the time I have absolutely no idea what you're saying." And he was always confused. He never, I mean, he acclimated as well as he could. He was a very take charge guy. But he was always like one step behind people. His plans never worked because he didn't understand, and not in a goofy way. Don't misunderstand me. He had the best of intentions and the best ideas, but he was outclassed a lot of the time because he was still playing catch up in some ways. I mean, he was definitely a cowboy and a cavalier, and he could take control of the situation, but he was almost learning as he went every single episode. He just learned very quickly. And of course, he had the love interest, which was the strong female character, the military character, like Wilma Deering. They had Rigel, which I guess is the closest you could get to Tweaky, you know, kind of a short, goofy character. But I always find it interesting that not a lot of people talk about that in connection, because I feel like, at least in its most basic elements, it ripped off Buck Rogers.
Farscape is a little obscure.
It is.
Only,
although it ran 4 seasons.
Yeah, but only sci-fi nerds like us remember that show.
Maybe so, but I find it interesting that you got where I was going.
Yeah, but admittedly, I hadn't thought about it until you started connecting the dots for
right,
me.
Right.
But to put it back to Buck Rogers,
yeah.
I remember it fondly. I don't think I'd ever want to go back to it. It's something I'd want to retain in memory because I feel like I would ruin it if I went back and tried to watch it and love it again. It just wouldn't hold up.
It wouldn't hold up.
It would disappoint me. So I'll just leave it as is. I'll just watch clips on YouTube and laugh at it and say, "Oh, I remember then."
Well, I showed you not that long ago a retrospective of Buck Rogers, and they show a lot of clips and they talk about the folly of what happened with season 2. And it's actually kind of hard to watch because, yes, our memory is of a certain show that it actually wasn't, you know?
Right.
And like you, I almost don't want to go back. Like, I want to give our brother that season setback and just say, I'm going to leave it where it is.
Well, you know, that retrospective actually tainted my memory.
Exactly.
Because I had no idea it was retooled.
Right.
And that it went down the drain as soon as season 2 started, mm-hmm. and people kind of abandoned it. And then it was this major conflict with my memory because I don't remember that at all. I just remember liking all of it, and I loved the Hawk character. And my little child brain didn't know what retooling a show was. Retooling, I'll retool you.
Yeah.
Somebody had to say that. But even watching that retrospective was enough to kind of
sour it
a little bit. So I figured, yeah, probably shouldn't go back and watch it. Yeah. It's probably not going to be helpful.
I agree.
But hey, it was fun talking about Buck Rogers. Thanks, Justin.
You're welcome, Josh.
All right. If you guys out there listening, if you want to write us, let us know if this is a good show or a bad show. Let us know. Good idea or not. Hey, let us know. Give us a writing. Give us a rating. Give us a like. Leave us a comment.
Or if you have a remember that topic you maybe want us to cover.
Or ways we can improve it. Anything. Yeah. We really want to hear from you because, like we said with the other episode, just a demo. So, hey, write in. Let us know. Thanks a lot. Good night.
Thank you. Good night.